It's been extremely exciting. We never thought a toy, a simple toy like a yo-yo, would bring such success and great opportunities for him.
My name is Hairston, and I'm the Hurricane.
I'm going to be doing a volunteer performance for the Nikkei Center today, and so I'm going to do a demonstration, I'm going to do a few songs, and so yeah.
Can everyone please welcome Harrison Lee.
Harrison Lee is a 15-year-old world-renowned yo-yo champion. He picked up his first yo-yo at the age of 10 and rose to fame in 2013, when he became Canada's national champion. Since then, Harrison has been traveling around the world, showcasing his amazing talent.
I started yo-yoing about 5 years ago. Mm-hmm. One of my friends bought a yo-yo to school, and I asked him if I could try, and so I've been yo-yoing ever since that day. I create my routine, and then I practice them over again, and then I focus on specific tricks, build on those tricks, and then I'm set. I normally yo-yo in front of the mirror so I can see all my tricks and I can always improve them. It depends. If I'm preparing for a competition, I normally practice for maybe 3 hours a day, but casually I may practice for one or two. I really like the creative aspect of yo-yoing because yo-yoing is limitless. You can do so many cool things with the yo-yo, and you can, if you move the string in one way, you create a whole new trick. So That's what I really enjoy about the yo-yo. My family is all very supportive, and they help me get to the competitions I want to go to, and they will always be there for me, and they'll always help me get to my goals.
Over the last few years, all our family vacations have been centered around all his yo-yo contests. But it's a lot of fun. He gets nervous up there, we get nervous with him. It's a simple toy, but there's still a lot of drama in it because all the players are very focused to win. And he gets up on stage, there's a lot of eyes on him, and a lot of things can go wrong.
I think I probably get, of the three of us, I probably get the most nervous because I just want him to not make any mistakes when he's up there. And especially, you know, I know how much work he's put into it. So you want to make sure that, you know, when he does do that performance, that final performance, that he does it perfectly.
Aside from winning many competitions during his career, Harrison has also made his very own yo-yo, which he often uses in his performances. Despite his young age, he's becoming a well-known philanthropist around the world, showcasing his unique talent.
I've done a few charities. The first one that I did was actually for the Calgary Flood Relief, and that was a couple of years ago. And so I did that in conjunction with the Salvation Army, and it was a one-day event, so I yo-yoed for the whole day. It was about 8 hours, and we were at Pacific Center, and we were able to raise over $2,000, so I was really happy with that. And then another event that we did was a few years ago, and that was with a local BC painter called Raymond Chow.
Raymond Chow, who's the renowned artist who's been around for decades. And he just so happened to see Harrison at one of the festivals, and he took some pictures, and he said he was going to paint him. And I thought, oh, that's kind of neat. And so when he said, oh, I finished all the paintings, I says, all the paintings? How many did you paint? He actually painted 8 paintings of him. And so we thought, you know, when we went to see it at the studio, I said, wow, this is so neat. And so Harrison said, you know, why don't we do something with this? And so what we did, we took the best 2 paintings, and we decided that what we would do is actually take it and make them into greeting cards. And from the greeting cards, he raised $4,500 for a Adopt-a-School program. So he was very, very proud of that.
The yo-yoing has definitely helped me grow as a person, and I feel like that's going to be very beneficial for me in the future.
Well, you know, when he came to us and said, I want a yo-yo, and he want to go all these contests, and well, we said to him, look, we see this as part of your personal development. If you can develop skills that you can take with you when you grow up from your experience with the yo-yo, we're behind you 100%. And I can see him 10, 15 years from now, he's got these skills in public speaking, he's got these skills in self-confidence and leadership. Now, yeah, he can take it to different places in life. Yeah. Your own passion doesn't have much meaning unless you can share it with the world. And if you can do something to help others, makes it that much more rewarding for him too.